What's up, guys? Charles here. NVIDIA's RTX 5060 is finally here, and many people hoped it had put up a fight against some of the best graphics cards. Does it really, though? Reviewers are split on the matter. Alas, I'm not here to judge the card. I'm here to show you some alternatives. While NVIDIA's 60 cards typically become some of the most popular GPUs of any given generation, they're not the only option you have right now. The RTX 5060 might not even be the best option at that price point. Below, I'll walk you through three GPUs that I think you should buy instead of the RTX 5060. The RTX 4060 is one of the last 40 series graphics cards that are still readily available around MSRP. I found one for $329 at Newegg, and it's an overclocked model, meaning slightly faster performance than the base version. And RTX 5060 and the RTX 4060 have a lot in common. Spec-wise, they're not at all far apart, although NVIDIA's newer Blackwell architecture switch to GDDR7V RAM give the newer GPU a bit more oomph. But unfortunately, both cards share the same 8GB RAM, an increasingly small amount in today's gaming world, and the same narrow 128-bit bus. Some reviewers note that the RTX 5060 isn't far ahead of the RTX 4060 in raw performance. However, the newer card gets the full benefit of NVIDIA's multi-frame generation. Overall, they're pretty comparable. I wasn't a big fan of the RX 7600X T16GB upon launch, and I still have some beef with that card. Much like NVIDIA's options, AMD equipped its mainstream GPU with a really narrow memory interface, stifling the bandwidth and holding back its performance. Still, in the current climate, I'll take that 16GB with the 128-bit bus over a card that has the same interface and only sports 8GB RAM. The cheapest RX 7600 XT 16GB costs around $360, and you can find it on the shelves with ease. The RX 7600 XT is slower than the RTX 5060, and it'll fall behind in ray tracing, but it gives you plenty of RAM, whereas NVIDIA's card offers very little. That alone makes it worthy of your consideration. If your budget is a little bit flexible, you could go one level up and get the RTX 5060 Ti with 16GB of RAM. Unfortunately, the cheapest options are at $479 right now. With 16GB of video memory and the full benefit of GDDR7, the RTX 5060 Ti 16GB offers an upgrade over the last-gen version. It's not perfect by any stretch, though. Reviewers put the GPU below the RX 9070 non-XT, the RTX 5070, and even the RTX 4070 when you consider pure rasterization. This means no so-called fake frames, which is what NVIDIA's DLSS4 delivers. That leaves the RTX 5060 Ti in an odd spot. Basically, if your budget can stretch to it, the RX 9070 and the RTX 5070 are both better cards. They're also a lot more expensive. That's it for today's video. Do consider subscribing for all the latest content on gaming, and as always, I'll see you at the next one. Peace out.